All right, Microsoft Copilot now can reason with the new strawberry model. Yes, so Microsoft Copilot, at least for those of you with Copilot Pro, the Pro subscription, now have access to the OpenAI O1 reasoning model. So before, this model was codenamed Q-Star, then codenamed Strawberry, but the O1 model is now available inside of Microsoft Copilot. And this allows Copilot Pro to think, right? To logic, to reason, right? To logically reason, I guess, right? To essentially, you know, take this chain of thought and it's going to happen under the hood. All right. So we're going to do a very quick overview, show you what this is, show you some of the pros and the cons. It was just released. I really hope Microsoft does some kind of UI UX updates, but let's just go ahead and tell you first a little bit more about what this is. So if you're new here, welcome to the channel. My name is Jordan Wilson, and this is Everyday AI. Aside from this YouTube channel, well, we're a daily podcast, live stream, and newsletter helping everyday people learn and leverage generative AI to grow their companies and careers. So yeah, we have almost like 400 episodes. You go learn for free from the world's leading experts. So make sure you go check out the website. All right, let's just jump straight into show you kind of what's coming with Microsoft Copilot. So they announced quite a few things, but this Think Deeper or the O1 model is one of them. They released the new interface, which I'll show you here in a second, as well as Copilot is supposed to be getting this vision, which is essentially a co-browsing capability inside of Microsoft Edge. So being able to talk to Copilot in these new kind of voices, right? These new voices. I already did a review of those, but similarly to OpenAI's advanced voice mode, you can kind of talk to these more neural advanced voices and browse the web and kind of just use it as a brainstorming strategy creative partner. But here's what we're going to be looking at, this new Think Deeper. So real quick, this is, we don't know which one it is, but this is either the O1 preview or the O1 mini model. That's important to keep in mind. Technically, the O1 model from OpenAI is not even available yet. So we only have access to O1 preview and O1 mini in the paid ChatGPT accounts. So I'm not sure which one we have access to in Microsoft Copilot. So again, you have to have a Copilot Pro account. So couple weird things, right? So this new interface is out. This is the new Copilot interface. If you are using Copilot Pro, if you have Microsoft 365 Copilot, you're going to have Biz Chat, which I believe does not look like this yet. It's going to look a little different. All right. So some things. So if you just click on Message Copilot, now you will see this new Think Deeper mode. Couple weird things with the interface here in a second. So I actually want to start a new chat with no context, right? So we can just test this out from scratch. So you're not going to click this plus button. That's actually to upload an image, which I know doesn't make a ton of sense. And you can't just click here because that takes you to your last chat. So you actually have to click this button again. This is the history button, and then click new chat. All right. So here's what we're going to do. I'm saying we are launching a new fitness app. Please analyze our customer data, or I'm actually going to take that part out. Let me just do this here, y'all. I don't want to have to type this live. Let me copy and paste it from my notes. This is unedited, unscripted for the most part. So I'm saying we are launching a new fitness app. Please identify the top three segments we should target based on age, activity level, and app usage patterns. Provide reasoning for why these segments are ideal and suggest the best marketing strategy for each. Also, please write me simple landing page copy for each segment, as well as a 3 drip email marketing campaign sequence. I should say probably for each segment. So we should get a total of 9. So this is actually a somewhat complex request that we're going to be asking Microsoft Copilot. So if you did this to a normal model that doesn't reason, the results would probably be a little dry and a little bland. So here's the thing that's right away a little weird. So this little toggle here, the Think Deeper, don't like it. It's confusing. And it always defaults to the last used state. All right. So that's important. So this looks like, at least to me, that Think Deeper is off, because it's like, oh, well, yeah, I want to use Think Deeper, so I should click that. And then I think this is how you use it, but you don't. It's actually very confusing. I don't like this interface. So this is actually on. So if you see the words Think Deeper, it's actually on, even though it seems like, oh, it's a verb. If you want to click deeper, if you want to think deeper, click that to use it. So yeah, I don't like it. A very simple fix, Microsoft peeps, because I know we got a lot of you tuning into this channel. Just make it a color, right? When you click it, get rid of this arrow and make this turn peach or tan or whatever color that is. This is extremely confusing, and I think people don't like it. All right, so let's go ahead and click it, and let's see how this new Think Deeper works. So you see right there, you see this little animation. So that's how I know that it's working. So if you hover over this, it's well, now it says stop thinking deeper, so I don't want to interrupt it. But when you hover over it, it says it may take up to 30 seconds. So this is kind of like chain of thought reasoning that's going on under the hood. Unfortunately, you can't really see what's going on, which I'm not a huge fan of. I think with generative AI and large language models, we need to increase the transparency. So then when I'm done, I don't get to see any more information, which kind of stinks, right? However, the big thing is, well, did this actually do what we told it to? So we asked it for a lot, right? And it took a good 20 to 30 seconds. So let's see if it did it. So it should have identified three different segments. It should have given us reasoning and rationale why those three segments are segments that we should go after. It should have given us a marketing strategy, landing page copy, and a three-drip email sequence. So we asked for a ton from this model. So we'll do the same thing without using Think Deeper, and we'll kind of quickly look at the results, but let's see, did it actually fulfill our requests? All right, so here's segment one, tech-savvy millennials. It gave us the group, the app usage patterns, why they're ideal, marketing strategy, okay? So it didn't give us everything. Maybe that's at the bottom. Here's segment two, busy professionals, okay, why they're ideal, marketing strategy. So, all right, so far, okay. Segment three, wellness-seeking seniors. You know, it's pretty interesting here. It looks like 30 to 45. So they left out the 45 to 55 group, 25 to 35. And there's some overlap too. So that's interesting, right? So what happens if you're 32? It looks like you fall in segment one and segment two, but that's okay. Not terrible. All right. So it did a good job. It broke down our segments. It gave us some reasoning why. I mean, it looks like, you know, pretty good, right? So as an example, it said seniors are very community oriented. It said you really need to, a marketing strategy with this demographic is you need to simplify the navigation. So at least the content and what it gave us, pretty good, seems sound, right? All right. Also, yeah, this is good. So partnerships, it said collaborate with healthcare providers and community centers. So, you know, overall, the output is good. Let's see if it gave us everything. Here's landing page copy. All right, so it didn't give us full copy. It really just gave us, this looks like the copy that you would use above the fold. So that was part of it, was my prompting was very ambiguous, right? So I should have maybe included, you know, hey, give me one H1 tag, three H2s, give me at least, you know, 300 words. But it gave us what you would presumably put above the fold. That's what it looks like. Okay, and then let's see if it gave us a three-drip email campaign. All right, so it looks like here's our tech-savvy millennials. Okay, gave us three emails. It gave us subject line, kept it simple. Okay, not bad. Busy professionals. All right, again, the emails are better, right? So here it's focusing on your time matters. Make the most of it, because this segment was, hey, they're too busy to work out, so you need the workout app. All right, not bad. And then wellness-seeking seniors. All right. So yeah, it's even funny. They, even the emojis seem a little age appropriate, right? Although in theory, I probably would have done these without emojis for some of the older groups. All right. And then it also went into beyond the basics, which is interesting. I didn't even ask for this, but it said, imagine your app as a bridge connecting diverse paths through, of life through fitness. So it even went kind of further and gave me even more information than I asked. So overall, if we're just judging by output, this was pretty good. This was okay. All right, so now let's run this exact same prompt, but let's do it without using the Think Deeper. Okay, so that was using the O1 model. We don't know if that was O1 Previewer, O1 Mini. It's another video for another day. So now I'm going to paste in the same prompt and I'm going to toggle this off. So again, I don't like this UI UX, extremely confusing. So when I click that, now it's actually off. So now when I click the send button there, this animation, that was not Think Deeper. This is just using now the GPT-4o model. So pros and cons, right? I don't think that the insights are going to be as deep here, but a pro by not using Think Deeper is it cites the sources, which I think is extremely important. So right now, the Think Deeper, the O1 model does not cite sources. So if you want to check something, you can't, right? At least by now, by default. So again, one of the biggest things with AI implementation is transparency. You want to be able to see what this large language model is actually using. What is it spitting out, right? And here we get, at least we can check something. So one other thing is, well, I should have access to real-time information. So I can say, you know, please find 2024 fitness trends and update this accordingly, right? So now, okay. It didn't look like it used Browse with Bing. I probably should have told it to. So I'm going to try that one more time. I'm going to say, please use Browse with Bing and do deeper research, right? So let's see if that works once this is done. All right. All right. So that was very quick. I don't know if it actually went out and did additional research, but let's go back to our other there we go. This is our original. So the other thing is, right, when you have multiple chats, I go in here and I technically now have no clue what model was used here. So another big, right, I think sometimes when companies try to simplify for UI UX, now I don't know, did I use the Think Deeper model in here or did I use the regular model? Right. So it always defaults to the last state, which is also confusing, right? Because I was using on this chat, I remember because this one, you know, I just went through it a little more step by step. It used the Think Deeper model. So when I do this and I'm going to say, you know, have it, you know, use Browse with Bing, it should tell me it can't. So a downside to this model, which is pretty big, it cannot access real-time information from the web. That is a huge drawback, but it's the same thing right now with ChatGPT if you are using the O1 model. So you'll see here, I should at least get, I think, an error message that says, hey, I can't access real, you know, real-time information from 2024. There we go. Interesting. So now it's even doing this. So I believe this might be considered a hallucination because it cannot access. So I did a test on this before. So now I'm going to say, I'm going to put in a specific date. So I'm going to say October 2024 fitness trends. When I did a test of this before, it correctly told me, it said, hey, my knowledge cutoff is October 2023, therefore I cannot give you 2024 trends. So let's go here to the bottom. Let's see if by asking for a specific date, if it's going to tell me, hey, you know what? I can't actually give this to you. So, you know, generative AI, you're going to get different results each time. And it's important to know what information it can. So here it fessed up. It said, hey, I hear you want the latest insights. Although I don't have access to data from October 2024, I can extrapolate upcoming trends based on the momentum of the industry up to October 2023. So in this case, when I told it to, sorry, I know I'm scrolling a lot here. So this was, it looks like just a hallucination. So it just said, hey, I don't have access to this, but it seems like this is what you want. Here you go. So again, I think that Microsoft needs to update this under the hood, needs to be a little more strict with the guardrails and let you know, hey, if you're using this Think Deeper model, it can't actually update, can't access the web. You might see or think, well, oh, looks like I can upload a file. Well, you can't. On this newer version, you can only upload JPEGs and PNG. So I'm going to upload this and I'm going to say, you know, just tell me about this image, right? And it actually just gives you, it doesn't even give you an error. It just looks like it just disappears, right? I've tried this multiple times. So you can't upload documents. If you think like, oh, here's a new feature that's not available in ChatGPT, think again. All right, so now let's just quickly do the exact same thing in 01 preview so you can kind of see a difference, how this is different. So you might be saying, okay, well, should I use this? Well, if you do not have access or maybe you cannot use ChatGPT at work, maybe you'll use Copilot Pro and use the Think Deeper there. But if you do have access to a ChatGPT Plus account, I don't really see a big reason, at least right now, to use the Think Deeper model by Microsoft Copilot. One of the main reasons is, well, a couple reasons. One is transparency. Here, when you use the 01 model, you can click and you can see exactly what the model thought under the hood. Why that's important is if something is wrong, you at least know that it gave you information based on something that you did not want. And I think even just reading this information right here is huge. I think so many people are skipping out on this. This lets you know how this model thinks and reasons. And again, it's going to be different every time. Generative AI is like rolling the dice, right? Which is why you really need this extra step of transparency. And you really need to be able to see under the hood what it's thinking and what it's not in case it's taking you in a direction or your business or your project in a direction that you don't want it to. So without being able to see under the hood, you cannot course correct or update the results unless you just can kind of see, oh, by these results, it looks like it took it in a direction that I did not want it to go. So actually very nice response here from ChatGPT. Looks pretty nice and well thought out. So you might be thinking, should I use this new Think Deeper, right? It depends, right? Like I said, if you have access, if you have access to ChatGPT Plus, I probably wouldn't use it. But if you don't, it's worth using. All right. I hope this was helpful. If so, please let me know in the comments. And please subscribe to this channel. Go to youreverydayai.com. Sign up for that free daily newsletter. Go check out all the information we have there. And we'll see you back for another AI in 5. Thanks, y'all.